This is To the Muse by James Wright. It is all right. All they do is go in by dividing one rib from another. I wouldn't lie to you. It hurts like nothing I know. All they do is burn their way in with a wire. It forks in and out a little like the tongue of that frightened garter snake we caught at Cloverfield, you and me, Jenny, so long ago. I would lie to you if I could. But the only way I can get you to come up out of the suck hole, the south face of the Powhatan pit, is to tell you what you know. You come up after dark, you poise alone with me on the shore, I lead you back to this world. Three lady doctors in Wheeling open their offices at night. I don't have to call them, they're always there. But they only have to put the knife once under your breast. Then they hang their contraption, and you bear it. It's awkward a while. Still, it lets you walk about on tiptoe if you don't jiggle the needle. It might stab your heart, you see. The blade hangs in your lung and the tube keeps it draining. That way, they only have to stab you once. Oh, Jenny. I wish to God I had made this world this scurvy and disastrous place. I didn't. I can't bear it either. I don't blame you, sleeping down there, face down in the unbelievable silk of spring, muse of black sand, alone. I don't blame you. I know the place where you lie. I admit everything. But look at me. How can I live without you? Come up to me, love, out of the river, or I will come down to you. Yeah. I part of what blows my mind about this poem is that he can say things like, oh, Jenny, and how can I live without you, which are some of the most maybe cliche, awful things that one could say in a poem, particularly a love poem. And yet, whenever I hit the end of this poem, I always feel like my heart's being ripped out. You know, it's just incredibly powerful, and it's really a testament to him as a writer.